Yaffa Hyphet. The legendary ones, Yaffa Hyphet, which I will talk about today. I will tell about his childhood, his one education, at a young age, his future, yes, and many more. Have a good time, everyone. Hyphet was born into a Russian family. His father, Ravon Hyphet, was a local violin teacher and was also a conductor. When Yaffa was a baby, his father wondered how he would react to his son's violin. Something told him that Yaffa had great potential. And before Yaffa was two, his father bought him a small violin and taught him how to draw a bow, how to hold it, and the basics about the violin. His father was also a violinist, so it was he provided little Yaffa's violin development. Yaffa was getting better every day. It was moving at an accepted speed for a child. And Hyphet's brother said he became a man after the age of 7, so after he was introduced to music, he was a boom before him. He started lessons with Elias Malkin at the age of 4. Hyphet was a genius, making his public debut at the age of 7 in Kolno, playing Felix Mendelssohn Violin Concerto in E minor. In 1910, he entered the St. Petersburg Conservatory to study alongside Onus Nalbandian. Hyphet could not be prevented. Hyphet played in Germany and Scandinavia and met Fritz Kreisler for the first time at a private press conference on 1912. And Hyphet was preparing for a big concert. Hyphet performed in most countries of Europe when he was a teenager. In 1911, he performed at an open-air concert in St. Petersburg in front of 25,000 spectators. Hyphet played so magnificently that he was messed up by the audience. Everybody wanted the young Hyphet. The conductor said that he had never heard such a brilliant violinist before. Hyphet also gave another concert at the age of 12. And at that concert he played Mendelssohn A minor violin concerto. Among the participating names was Fritz Kreisler. Kreisler told everyone, "We can break our violins on our knees." A piece of news came from the Los Angeles Times. It was written that Hyphet was the greatest violinist after Paganini. The New York Times music critic Harold Schomburg said he set all the standards for violin playing in the 20th century. And also, legendary violinist Isaac Perlman said the fact that no violinist to come after him will be better than him is quite depressing. Other critics claim that his play conveys emotion and respect, quick vibrato, intense feeling. The use of fast tempo and excellent bow control are Hyphet's playing techniques. It can be instantly recognized by the curious. Known for its rich warm tone, Isaac Perlman describes Hyphet's playing as whirlwind because of its emotional intensity. Perlman said Hyphet preferred to record relatively close to the microphone. and as a result, a slightly different tone quality would be perceived when listening to Heifetz during a concert hall performance. And Heifetz was meticulous about his choice of strings. Heifetz was also benevolent and environmentally friendly. Later in his life, he was a teacher devoted to protecting the environment and a defender of sociopolitical goals. He publicly advocated the use of 911 as an emergency telephone number and fought for clean air. He and his students at the University of Southern California protested against air pollution by wearing gas masks. And it's very interesting. In 1967, he converted the Renault brand car into an electric car. Heifetz's son, Yair Heifetz, is a professional photographer. He was former marketing director of the Los Angeles Philharmonic and Hollywood Bowl and chief financial officer of Paramount Pictures Worldwide Video Division. Lives and Works in Fremantle, Western Australia. Heifetz's daughter, Josefa Heifetz-Brain, is a lexicographer who is the author of the Unusual website. And in addition to this, Heifetz has been married twice. And let me tell you an interesting story. After his recital in Jerusalem, Heifetz was attacked by a young man who hit his violin box with a crowbar. Heifetz was used to an invulnerable right hand in that attack. The attacker escaped and was never found again. That attack was attributed to Kingdom of Israel terrorist group. The event made headlines and Heifetz definitely announced that he would not stop playing Strauss. But threats continued to come and he removed Strauss, he told Explanton at his next recital. His right hand was damaged and hurt in that attack. 3-4, his last concert was cancelled. He left Israel and did not return until 1970. Heifetz talked violin extensively to his students, first at UCLA and then master classes at the University of Southern California, which included renowned cellist Gregor Patagorsky and violist William Primrose at the faculty. For several years in the 1980s, he talked at his private studio at his home in Beverly Hills. The teaching workshop can be seen today in the main building of the Colburn School and inspires the students there. Throughout his teaching career, Heifetz has taught names such as Eric Friedman, Pere Amiel, Adam Hankowski, Rudolf Kohlmann, Andrea Granat, Teyi Okubo, Egona Fodor, Paul Resantol, Ilka Talvi, and Ike Agus, among others. In the last decade of his life, Heifetz visited Hans Binnink in his workshop Colored Binnink's Violins, for the maintenance of the 1740 Guarnieri violin. This Guarnieri can currently be taken out and played at the San Francisco Legion of Honor Museum, as instructed in Heifetz's will, only by disarming ones on special occasions. The instrument was recently loaned to Alexander Brunschlick, the concert conductor of the San Francisco Symphony, and was played in 2006 with Andrei Garbotenko and the San Francisco Academy Orchestra. In 1989, Heifetz received the Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award posthumously. Heifetz passed away at the age of 86 at the Cedar Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles, California, following his fall at home on December 10. Heifetz has played many works during his lifetime, and his works have indeed been played perfectly. I have listened to many of Heifetz's works, and indeed, they were all played in a unique style. Heifetz has especially performed works in classical and romantic style, and the order of the works that should be listened to is as follows. Paganini, Capriccio 24, Sarasate, Zigeuner Weigand, Sarasate, Zapeacedo, Tchaikovsky, Violin Concerto, His Cadenza, Wieniawski, Giorgio Tarantella, Mendelssohn, Violin Concerto in E minor, Saint-Saëns, Rondo Capriccio, and Ora Staccato. All of these works are flawless, you must listen to. I tried to explain the biography of Heifetz for you. I hope it was useful. For more biography, don't forget to support me. Grazie, maestro.